everyone, and welcome to Cafe Rouge Chapter 6. We are one chapter away until we're almost finished. Now, hopefully we're gonna find out what the hell is going on, because we're adopted, and we don't know what we are. I have a clue to what we are, but Isis doesn't. Welcome to Cafe Rouge, how may I help you? It was another usual day at the cafe. The brilliant sunshine beat down on the tables with a scintillating shine. As a cafe sign, I couldn't read sign, swung in the lingering breeze, people came to and fro, passing by the red scarlet door much more than usual today. Of course, that was to be expected. Tonight was going to be a special night. Ever since the horrible incident, the jazz night had been postponed till further notice. It didn't take too much persuasion convincing the band to come back despite the reluctance. After all, the place had a stage as grand as Café Rouge. Hello, how may I help you today? Annette, in spite of all the recent happenings, I'm surprised myself I still came back. One way or another, I was drawn to this place, whether by its beauty, its liveliness, or its sheer feeling of nostalgic happiness. I couldn't describe it. I should be getting back inside soon. Carrying my tray full of empty glasses, I walked back toward the scarlet door. Oh, look at that. It says vanilla ice cream on it. Whatever was going to happen was going to happen. But tonight, I was going to forget myself in the luscious music of sweet jazz. Here's some more glasses, Aldo.
Man, you just say all sorts of random shit that I can't pronounce. The Kujuvam Silinoi Isis.
Heading out toward the door, Aldo suddenly grabbed my hand.
Wait, I think I'll be needing some help. Weaslow's muffins, take break from taking order.
And help me in kitchen, please.
Oh, sure then.
Obrigado. Nah. I hate you. Drag ingredients to bowl.
It's not that one.
Stir as quick as you can.
Like the world will end. Or like someone will stab you in the back. With a butcher knife. Scoop the batter out of the bowl.
I'm scooping batter out of the bowl onto a pan. I don't know what I'm making, but I'm gonna continue to do this because I was told to by Aldo. La la la
la la la. Oh, you whore. Two times it's freaking shit. And now to figure out what that is, because I know I failed. Okay. Frickin' math. I freaking hate math. It seemed like it was going easy until the stupid temperature thing came up, and then it's all like,
what's 2 times 10 to the second power plus, I think it was 50.
Oh, gotta throw math in my face.
Scooping up the batter and putting it on the pan. I don't know why I do this, cause it doesn't seem right, but whatever. I don't even know what we're making. La 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 la, just fling it onto the pan.
Yeah! Finito.
These muffins smell absolutely delish. Oh, we're making muffins? Probably told me that before and I just wasn't paying attention. The dining hall was crowded tonight. Standing in the dark, I stood concealed from the assembly of vampires sitting amongst the round tables of gold. Even though I was pretty far back, I was thankful the music was loud enough to echo throughout the dining hall to reach my ears. To miss a night like this would be absurd. Aha, playing hooky during your shift, kiddo. I whipped my head around, startled.
Oh, Chris, jeez, you sure scared me there.
Don't worry. I
What accent was that? Don't worry, your secret's safe with me.
Are you?
Yes, playing hooky to watch the performance, too. I'm so tired of serving beer to my regular drunks. Honestly, people don't have class this day and age. The small talk soon died off as we both turned our attention to the stage. We clapped our hands, applauding as the band started another number. But then my mind was completely gone, sucked in by the energy of the classy notes. It was really surprising when I felt that tap on my shoulder.
Hi, sis.
He grabbed my hand suddenly, pulling me towards him.
Chris, what are you?
We've been co-workers for a while now, haven't we, Isis? I know this might be so sudden, but talking with you and working with you, I've come to like you quite a lot.
But what do you mean?
Is there by any chance you feel the same way? Will you go out with me? My mouth gaped open in complete shock. I had no idea Chris thought of me that way.
Yes.
I don't know. He continued to smile at me, clenching my hand so I couldn't turn away. All I could do was stand there speechless as the blood rushed to my head, flushing my face crimson red.
I'm pretty sure she likes Valentino.
Okay, chapter. I don't know what my password is, so give me a second to get it, because I had to get the hell out of my stupid calculator. There.
I looked away, avoiding his eyes. Literally, I was speechless. What could I say to him?
My eyes darted back and forth, trying to distract myself with the glow of the yellow lights.
This is all so sudden, he laughed.
Don't you like me, Isis? We've been good friends, haven't we?
I do like you, I do, but
my thoughts wandered off.
Dude, back off. She's in love with Mr. Valentino. And if he wasn't in the picture, I would have been like, yes.
But I would like to remain loyal to the person that we've been with this entire time.
Valen's face came to my mind as I continued to look down, contemplating on a way to put Chris down easily.
I'm sorry. It's just, there's someone I like and... Just thinking about Valen made my heart race, but what if he rejects me like I'm rejecting Chris now? The thought of it made my guts turn.
Ooh, I think I'm realizing it now. There's someone else, right?
I blushed bright pink, nodding my head.
Is it that Michael's boy?
Immediately I look up. How did you...
Oh, everyone knows him. His family's quite infamous, you know. Valentino's his name, is it?
I look down, unable to keep the smile off my face. Eagerly, I start talking nonstop about him.
Yeah, he's really cute and he blushes all the time.
If I was Chris, I would have been like, whoa, this was not an invitation to spill your guts like that. Because this is weird. This is really weird and awkward for me.
I feel so bad for him, though. His mom gave him such a weird name.
I personally like the name, you buttface.
We're like childhood friends since daycare. His mom always set up play dates with us when we were little, so it was natural we became such good friends.
Just talking about him makes you dizzy, doesn't it, kiddo? I nodded my head embarrassed.
That's such a shame. It looks like you're taken, huh?
Aw, poor thing.
Yeah, I'm sorry, Chris. It's perfectly fine, Isis, but... He brought my hand up and gave a chaste kiss to my fingers. Smiling, Chris ruffled my hair.
If you ever are available, make sure I'm at the top of your list.
Wink.
I flushed, looking down at Chris as Chris continued to grin at me.
He patted my back and let go of my fingers. I should be getting back to the bar. Maybe we should get back to the... You should get back to the kitchen, too.
Waving, Chris walked off, leaving me in the dark corner. The blush still lingered on my face as I stood alone with my thoughts about Valen.
What if he does reject me? What if he just wanted to be friends?
They're, like, close calls where he's all like, I love you.
So, I'm pretty sure he won't reject you.
And if he does, we'll just kick him in the balls. And strangle him a little bit.
Because he deserves it after what he did with the blood sucking.
I'm gonna go home.
Please, don't come out and kill me, Mr. Invisible Shadow Man. Cause that's gonna suck for me. Cause I don't know where I'm going. And it's really annoying when I have to look up where to go. So I can't sing, but I like to do this anyways.
Oh, jeez.
Oh yay, we made it home. I don't know how we did it, but we did. The glaring sun greeted me. I could barely feel my fingers stretching my arms in the usual morning ritual. Something was off. Yes, the air felt weird, humid, yet dry. Did I have a fever? My hand reached up to my forehead, waiting with bated breath. No, my temperature felt normal. Weird. Whatever. I should head to school. To school. The weather felt so dry today, unusually so. Ignoring the uncomfortable atmosphere, I watched my classmates going to and fro into the classroom. Everybody stand for the pledge. With as much leverage as I can, I rose from my seat. Reciting the same words I repeated every morning, my gaze wandered down to my desk, not caring to look at the flag. Ow! I turned to stone. Automatically, my eyes darted to the source. A classmate stood in the far corner with a small paper cut on her index finger. The drop was tiny, dripping millimeter by millimeter down her skin. I wanted to puke. How did you see that? Miss Black? Hey, Isis, are you okay? Eyes rolling up, my body gave in. Ooh, it's gonna hurt when you hit the ground. The black flooded into my vision and the lights went out in my mind. The light of the nurse's office blinded me. Blinking several times, I lifted off the bed covers. The nurse was right next to me, checking for my glucose level with one of those diabetes thingies. Oh gosh, it was so much worse today. I felt so sick. That's nice, dear. Let's have you eat your medication now. That's nice, dear, that you felt so sick today. Now, here, let me shove these pills down your throat. With her nimble finger, she dropped two small pills into my palm. Leaving me with a cup of water in one hand, she left to care for the others. Ugh, I didn't want to eat them. But if I didn't, I'd probably still have this horrible headache. I slipped the pills on the table, pulled the covers back over my head. Everything still felt very groggy, despite everything I tried. Closing my eyes, I tried to fall asleep. Isis? I recognized that voice. Pulling my covers off, I lifted myself up on the bed. Val, what are you doing here? Sitting down beside me, he took my hand in his. Are you okay? Yeah, I just fainted again. Some stupid idiot cut her finger. Whoa! Hey! Paper cuts! You don't just, like, do that because you, like, do that. Freaking paper is evil sometimes. And despite carefully holding that paper, you still get a dang paper cut. It was such a tiny drop of blood, but it made me so nauseous. My head felt weird still, but with Val in here, everything felt better. He was my medicine, which reminded me. By the way, Val, where did you get my pills? Did you, like, steal some from the nurse? From the nurse's? Why don't you have pills in your home? In the nurse's office? That was the most likely explanation. Well, the door creaked open. It was a nurse.
Hide, Valen, quick!
Hide, Valen, fast! Well, they're both the same. I don't know what the frick is.
Val, get under the bed. Yanking his sports jacket, I pulled him to the ground. With enough common sense, he rolled underneath just as the nurse opened the door.
Did you eat your meds yet, dear?
Well, I need some more water. The old lady sighed, eyeing the uneaten pills on the side desk. I need to go to the teacher's lounge for a bit, dear, so eat your meds and rest for a while.
Okay. Aren't you gonna give me water?
Door closing, we were still for another 5 minutes. Can I come out now? Yeah. Slowly, he crawled out. It felt like old times when he'd sneak through my window and sleep next to me during a thunderstorm. He'd clung to me, shivering from the lightning strikes and sound of thunder. I laughed, remembering. What are you laughing about?
Remember when we were in grade school, you always sneaked over to my house during the storms? He flushed bright pink.
That was a long time ago. Laughter dying, I finally smiled, watching as Val took his place sitting beside my bed again. With nothing else to do, I reached for my pills. I should eat them now.
Wait.
He slapped my hand away as I reached out.
What? Val, what are you doing?
The next thing he did was really surprising. Lifting his hand up, he bit himself hard.
It's a sexual thing. Remember, in the beginning.
Valen, what the hell? Oh, Valen, what the hell are you doing? Leaning toward me, he cupped my face in one hand. His face leaned in slowly until he finally pressed his lips against mine.
Ew la la.
He's kissing me. kissing me. I was surprised at first, but then, as it prolonged, I gave in. I couldn't concentrate on anything except for the melting sensation I felt. His tongue traced along the lines of my lips,
and I obliged opening them. There was a funny taste in my mouth as I did so. I ignored it at first, but then I realized what that putrid taste was. Ugh! Oh, I'll ruin the moment, son of a bitch.
I gasped, breaking off the kiss. Coughing, I spat out the blood, coughing uncontrollably. What are you? Are you crazy? What are you thinking? Val's face was stricken with disappointment.
I wanted to make sweet bloody love to you.
He looked incredibly sad, like his hopes had been dashed. I softened, watching as tears suddenly leaked out of his eyes. Val? He didn't answer, lowering his head into my lap, crying. I patted his unburned hair, trying to comfort him. Do you ever think about the future? What? Val wiped away the tears, lifting up his face to look at me.
Let's run away. Let us run away together, mi amor.
What? Let's run away together, after we graduate high school, and go to Las Vegas.
Las Vegas, of all places, really.
Val, do you hear yourself right now? You sound like a crazy lunatic. What was he thinking, and why was he saying all this? The obvious answer eluded me, despite the kiss. I don't want to go through that stupid dating process asking you to go out with me. I want to immediately tell you, will you be my wife? He grabbed my hand, pulling me into an embrace. I want to marry you. I want to make sweet,
sweet sexual love to you.
Yeah. I want to sit on that porch someday with our kids and while holding our hands watching the sunset. I love you, Isis. Do you know that? I could hardly believe what I was hearing. Val continued to hold on to me, his hand stroking my hair. Vampires can watch sunsets? He laughed. Well then, I'm a different vampire. I don't need my mom. We can do everything ourselves. You can get a job and I can be a football star and go to the big bowl. We'll be rich. I mean, don't you feel the same, Isis? I love you. I love you too, Val. But in the back of my mind, reality hit me. What was he doing? Giving me promises that he knew he couldn't keep. He sounded so crazy. But what has this got to do with your mom? We jumped. The shock of the bell broke our moment together. The emotions finally settling down, Val let go slowly. Reaching out my hand toward him, I wiped the excess tears off his face. He was such a boy. Whatever happens, Val, we'll get through it together. We'll get through it together, okay? Yeah, okay. My throat hurts. My head still felt a little dizzy. Anyway, time to head to another day of work.
Great.
No matter how many times I do this, I still get lost. Oh, yay. I couldn't let my emotions control over what I have to do my job. Not only my job, though, but another thing. There was an investigation still needed to be done. Evidence was missing, and I was determined to find them.
I'm also slightly suspicious of Anthony.
Afternoon, Aldo. L'abdien, Miss Isis. What shall we do today? Aldo paused, looking over pots and pans. He seemed to be looking for something.
I don't think I'll be needing his help. But please tidy up the kitchen, if you please.
With that said, he left through the kitchen door. Guess I have some free time to myself. Time to investigate. Body area. Remembering the filthy stench of Errol and Adeline's bodies made me sick. It's been about a week now since their horrible deaths. I kneeled down to the ground engulfed in mourning once more. Was it better that I barely know them? That now I could easily forget them without a guilty conscience? But that wasn't true. I did have a guilty conscience. In the back of my mind, I knew it was somehow my fault they died. I'm so sorry. Who would remember them now? Their family? Their friends? Did they have any family or friends? And why didn't I bother to find out? Am I that horrible a person? If there was something I could do for them now, was to find justice for their deaths. Yes, that is what I must do. I headed out the kitchen door. That was all I could find for now, and I shouldn't be alone by myself. Who knows what I would do if the murderer found me? The red curtains were the first thing that drew my eye. Stepping up onto the stage podium, it was still quite messy from the jazz night. Seriously, wires were tangled everywhere. Ugh! I tripped, falling face first onto the stage. Wires thick and thin knotted my feet and arms, making it almost impossible for me to get up. Tangle myself. Okay. Okay, I can do this. I can do this. Taking deep breaths, I calm myself down. Slowly, carefully, my arms moved out of the tangle. Cautiously, I lifted myself up. Phew. I did it. Careful, dear. Did you fall down? Diane was walking up toward me. Yes, but I'm fine now. You should go and help Aldo now, don't you think? Actually, he needs some help right now in the dining hall. What? Come, dear, please.
Actually, now I'm also kind of suspecting Diane.
Now, just hit my little tissue box stand. The place was all a ruckus. Something small darted under the tables too fast for me to see.
It is a rat.
Aldo, as well as everyone, was everywhere, either dodging the small thing or chasing it. It's okay, don't run now. Suddenly, it dashed out right between my legs. I yelped and tripped, falling to the ground with a thud. At first, I thought it was a rat, but it was way too big for one, and too small for a cat. What? Ugh, Miss Isis, help us catch the little thing. But what? I screamed, something touching my behind. Immediately, I scrambled up and jumped onto the table. Eek! Don't run so much, Aldo. You'll only encourage it. Scusa, scusa. Freaked out of my mind, I panicked again when the thing raced down right under us. Aldo followed and dove beneath.
It's a piggy!
Oink, oink. Hey, none of our powder, poco grasso.
Butchering all of the languages.
He wrapped the creature in a big bundle of cloth. It was too concealed for all of us to see. What is that thing? Did it just snort? Oh my goodness, you have a pig.
Oh, it's so cute!
He lifted a tiny cover, revealing the pink thing. Its eyes were barely open now and tired of the chase. Diane and I swarmed around Aldo, trying to take a closer look at the teacup pig.
Oh, that's why he was all freaking suspicious, because he has a little piggy wiggy.
Such an adorable... Oh, look at it. The eyes are even more irresistible and puppy dog eyes. Where did you even get this? Damien interrupted, grabbing Aldo's shoulder.
Whoa. I can't remember the last time anybody, walked into the thing. It might be because I've been staring at the speech the entire time.
Aldo, didn't Anthony talk to you yesterday? You can't bring animals into the cafe. This is the third time you sneaked your pig in.
I'm very sorry.
The chef lowered his head in shame. Still, I wasn't going to let my curiosity go unanswered. But Aldo, where in the world did you get this little guy anyway?
Oh, I was visiting the farmers markets all over town last week. I was only looking for veggies, but then I saw a pen full of small piglets, teacup piglets. They were too small to be given to pork manufacturers, especially this one. And if I didn't bought it, the farmer would have put them down.
Laughing a little humorlessly, Aldo leaned down to tickle his pet. We smiled, watching the piglet squirm in delight. Then I realized something. Was a teacup pig why you were gone from the cafe for so long? Aldo nodded.
My landlady doesn't allow animals, so I brought him here temporarily. But he's not allowed here too, so I don't know what to do.
But that means Aldo's completely ruled out as a suspect then.
What's the same? I actually haven't named it yet.
Well, name it later. Come on, everybody, back to work.
Your pig's caused enough trouble as it is. We have to set up all the tables again.
And the night hours start in less than 2 hours. Clapping his hands, we all shut our mouths, scrambling ourselves to get back to work. Aldo bowed again in apology as Damien gave a private scolding in the kitchen. We were obviously smitten with the little thing, but it looked like we'll never see it again.
At least investigation ended at a good note today.
Another day at the cafe was over. Honestly, though, I didn't want to go home, or what home did I have anyway? My parents didn't want me, and all they're concerned about is me moving out of their house. Maybe I should go back inside. I'm leaving a little early.
Go back and find Diane. Go back and find Aldo. Call Fallon. I want to play with a little piggy!
Aldo? Isis? What are you doing here? I don't know. Could I help you with anything? Aldo was busy mixing cake batter, probably for tomorrow. I sighed, looking around. I was so useless.
What's the matter?
Huh? You want to talk about it? I shook my head no. Aldo smiled, coming over and patting my head.
Then smile for me. I don't like frowns, you see?
He pulled the sides of my cheeks, smiling.
There, now that's a good girl. Whatever is bothering you, know this. You're young, your life's ahead of you, and you can always come here to get free food from meals, okay?
I love you. I love you forever.
Oh, forget Valen. Let's get with Aldo.
I'm home. Not that you guys want me. The living room is empty, and yet the light is still on. Oh, darling, you're home. A tall woman stepped down into the light. My mouth gaped open in surprise. Miss Michaels? What are you doing here? Oh, darling, of course I would come. I found out what happened. You did? I looked down a little ashamed. Mrs. Michaels reached for my face, tilting up my chin so that I would look at her. Oh, you poor thing. I think it's time I've told you something. Oh, man, I can't remember the thing that I wanted to remember, and now I can't say it. Mrs. Michaels brought me over to the living room couch, plotting me down like I was the guest in her house. You are a very special girl, Isis. Did you know that?
I am.
Oh, yes, so special that these very bad people called Red Bloods have been after your life ever since you were born.
What?
Shush, shush, shush. She playfully tapped my nose lightly with her finger. And so I took it upon myself to hide you and let you grow up in a normal environment and happy childhood. Though it didn't turn out that way, considering your horrible parents.
I hope you eat them, because they are the suckiest parents I have ever heard of. And I hate them so much. I hope you eat them.
So you're the woman they were talking about? Mrs. Michaels laughed, pulling my cheeks. Why, yes, my darling, I've been taking care of you ever since you were born, and really, I am so sorry for what happened. She took my hand in hers, grasping them tightly. I never imagined that would do anything like that to you. And if I had known sooner, I would have scooped you up and brought you to live with Valen and I.
Now I'm wondering if those bastards were the ones who were chasing after me that one night.
I flushed as she brought up Valen. I was so worried about him, his line cut off in the middle of our conversation. And I should tell her about my feelings for him. Of course, Mrs. Michaels noticed. Is there something you'd like to tell me, dear? Actually, I just wanted to let you know that I'm in love with with my son. How did you? Oh, darling, it's so obvious. Valen talked nonstop about you all the time. And the way you two look at each other, it was a match made in heaven.
Because I made the match.
My chest filled with joy hearing her words. So, I would love to have you as my daughter, dear.
I planned it this entire time.
The woman opened up her arms waiting, and I eagerly embraced her in a hug. Yes, Val and I would be one big happy family. Mrs. Michaels?
Yes, dear?
Where are my parents? She kissed my forehead, tapping my nose again. You don't have to worry about them anymore. They're gone. There was something off about her smile.
I killed them.
I hope she killed them, because frickin' they don't deserve to be alive. I'm just kidding. They don't deserve to die. They do deserve a kick in the nether regions. I couldn't put my finger on it, but I knew one thing for sure. Valen and I would be together, and that was all that mattered.
That was all that mattered.
I was in bed, frantic with worry. Valen still hadn't answered my calls and texts back. I asked Mrs. Michaels where he was, but she said he was out. Out where? Ow. My friggin' ears. My phone. Flipping it open, I gasped in horror. Come to cafe or he dies. It was an unknown number. I stiffened, realizing who it must be from. The murderer.
I'm going to get this bastard and I'm going to rip his nards off.
Jumping out of bed, I raced out of the house to meet my fate.
Trick 13.
What will happen in the last chapter of Café Rouge? Who is the bastard that stole our man? And will we get there in time? Who knows? We'll find out next time on Café Rouge, Chapter 7.
Hello, everyone, and welcome back to the Cafe Rouge, the last chapter, chapter 7. Now we're gonna see everything else that hopefully will tie together at what the hell is going on. I raced down the streets as fast as I could. The threatening text in my cell weighted down my pocket heavily. All I could think about was whether or not the killer left him safe and untouched. Please, I prayed. Let him be all right, please. Oh, great. Oh, great. I'm here. The door was left ajar. Reaching the scarlet door, I trembled in terror. What was it? Trick 13. Hello? My voice was barely a whisper. The cafe lobby was strangely dark and cold, and I had a bad feeling about coming in here so completely vulnerable. Panic rushed through me as I realized another mistake. What if he wasn't even here? What if this was all a trick for the murderer to lead me here alone? No. Oh no, I had to. Hello, Isis. A shimmer of metal flashed before my eyes, and suddenly my neck slid open.
Great, we just died.
Warm liquid cascaded down my body. In the last second of consciousness, I realized it was blood. The floor met my face as I greeted the pool of red, and the lights went out of my mind.
You son of a bitch!
I wonder if we could go to Val's house, but I don't know where his house is. Okay, hold on. Tra la la la, gonna go look at stuff.
Is this the end? Am I dead?
Okay, so it seems that I have the freaking bad end. So, I'm guessing I have no choice. I have the bad end, and that's it. So, that's the end of that. Which really sucks. Because I don't really want to have to go back and get all the endings, because it's such a pain in the ass. And I guess I'll probably go. I might find a walkthrough, maybe, to do this. But really, in the end, this is the end. I'm dead. Because nothing gets tied up and tells me what the hell's going on with this freaking thing. Because I got the bad end and it sucks to be me. If anyone wants me to actually try to get the good ending for this, then post a comment and I'll get back to this. But I guess that's it. I came here, it's freaking ended so fast. My mind is just like bam. I don't know why she ran there. I don't know why she decided that, oh, hey, I'm not gonna friggin' think this through. I'm just gonna run there with no weapon at all. Like a dumb bitch. I'm trying to read the comments at the same time. I'm trying to talk, but it's really hard to do that. But I know that there is an ending. The ending that I got is finito. That's it.
no direction I take will take me to his house, I guess. It's not like I'm gonna try because I don't know how to get there. But, yeah, if you guys want me to, get the endings, the good endings and whatever, I'll look up a walkthrough, but only if, like, at least one person says, can you do this? Because I don't really wanna. This friggin' little game things and walking from home to work and stuff is a pain in the ass. And why is there cake outside? Whatever. I'm out. After this, I'll be getting the star-stealing prince up. Of course, I still gotta record it. But I'll get it recorded and edited and posted up so that it gets to the finished of it. Because that thing needs to be done. I'll see you guys in whatever I make next. Ciao for now.